was the worst environmental disaster in this part of the United States. It occurred in the mid-1930s when farming conditions from the years before that, when prices were so good during World War I and afterwards, caused a lot of farmers to put a lot more of this kind of land into production that was mainly just for buffalo grazing or cattle grazing before that, causing all that land to be blown up during the height of the drought. There wasn't enough cover to hold down that soil.
I guess you've heard about every kind of blues, but when the dust gets high, you can't even see the sky. I've seen the dust.
About 80 years ago, farmers from the Midwest had suffered through what is now known as the Dust Bowl, a defining aspect of the Great Depression in 1930s America. With this, a spur of great migration to the deep American West occurred, with 500,000 people leaving their farms for the California border, 1,000 miles away to seek work. The journey was marked by the great American novel, The Grapes of Wrath, which was written by a California native by the name of John Steinbeck.
It blowed my fences down, buried my tractor 6 feet underground.
Born in the Salinas Valley in 1902 to John Ernst and Olive Steinbeck, the child was shy and smart, deciding that he would become a writer at the age of 14. His parents stated that he would lock himself in his bedroom to write poems and stories.
From age 14 until he died at age 66, he wrote every day. He wrote letters, he wrote journals to kind of warm up, and then he would write for, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 hours a day.
By 1919, Steinbeck enrolled at Stanford University, but the aspiring writer would prove to have little use for college, dropping out in 1925. After Stanford, Steinbeck took on work as a caretaker in Lake Tahoe, where he would write his first novel, Cup of Gold, based on the life and death of 17th century privateer Henry Morgan. It was during this time that he married his first wife, Carol Henning, who supported Steinbeck as he enveloped himself in his writing. He then wrote two more novels, The Pastures of Heaven, about the Corral de Tierra in Monterey, and To a God Unknown, my personal favorite, exploring the relationship of a man to his land. Gravitating toward the rustic landscape of America, Steinbeck grew a personal attachment to the working-class ranch people early on, painting them as the heroes of his novels, as in his next novel, Tortilla Flat, which depicts a small band of countrymen enjoying life and wine in the days after the end of the Great War. The novel earning Steinbeck his first commercial success. Following his success, Steinbeck wrote Of Mice and Men, which tells the tale of George and Lenny who move from place to place in California in search of job opportunities, depicting the sad and solitary life of the people Steinbeck so deeply sympathized with.
Guys like us that work in ranches are the loneliest guys in the world. They got no family, they don't belong no place. Come to a ranch and work up a stake, and then they go into town and blow their stake, and first thing you know, they're pounding their tail at some other ranch. He ain't got nothing to look ahead to.
He was drawn to people who weren't in the mainstream. Workers in the fields, people who were lonely, people who were isolated, people on the margins. He always defended those who suffered in some way.
Perhaps his most ambitious novel, The Grapes of Wrath, was published in 1939. Telling the story of a rundown Oklahoma family and their struggle to make a new life in California at the height of the Great Depression. The book captured the angst of the nation during this time period, leading Steinbeck to be called a communist by American politicians as the book was selling 10,000 copies per week, the height of its popularity. The work would eventually earn Steinbeck a Pulitzer Prize in 1940.
Oh. We're strangers here, mister. We heard about there was work in a place called Tavares.
Yeah, well, you're heading the wrong way. What's more, we don't want no more Okies in this town.
As he grew older, Steinbeck served as a war correspondent for the New York Herald Tribune during World War II, where he gathered intel on the Nazi Party. Around the same time, he traveled to Mexico to collect marine life specimens with his friend Edward Ricketts, a marine biologist. Their collaboration resulted in the book Sea of Cortez, which analyzed the beauty of the underwater creatures, with Steinbeck quoted saying, "Religion, or mystical outcrying, is really the understanding and the attempt to say that man is related to the whole thing. Plankton, spinning planets, and an expanding universe, all bound by the elastic string of time." He would then later continue writing, realigning himself with his original passion, the American landscape. Publishing Cannery Row, about a street lined with sardine canneries during the Great Depression, Burning Bright, an experimental play based not on a plot but detailed scenes on the main character and his environment, and his biblical creation story epic, East of Eden, which brings in the intricate stories of two interwoven families. Finally, in 1962, at the age of 60, Steinbeck was awarded the Nobel Prize, attesting to his greatness as a writer.
Literature is as old as speech. It grew out of human need for it, and it has not changed except to become more needed. The skalds, the bards, the writers are not separate and exclusive. From the beginning, their functions, their duties, their responsibilities have been decreed by our species. Humanity has been passing through a gray and desolate time of confusion. My great predecessor, William Faulkner, speaking here, referred to it as a tragedy of universal fear, so long sustained that there were no longer problems of the spirit, but only the human heart in conflict with itself seemed worth writing about. Fearful and unprepared, we have assumed leadership over the life or death of the whole world, of all living things. The danger and the glory and the choice rest finally in man. The test of his perfectibility is at hand. Having taken godlike power, we must seek in ourselves for the responsibility and the wisdom we once prayed some deity might have. Man himself has become our greatest hazard and our only hope.
Steinbeck would eventually die, 6 years later, of heart disease on December 20th, 1968, at his home in New York City. But perhaps his legacy can be reminded by the Hebrew word, the word timchel, thou mayest, that gives a choice. Used in his book East of Eden, the quote reads, "It might be the most important word in the world, that says the way is open, that throws it right back on the man, for if thou mayest, it is also true that thou mayest not."
Mm-hmm.